Radiant Team Ban. Dire Team Ban. Remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to another game in the KOD League Season Number 2, Mad Kings versus Doo-Wop Game Number 2. I am your caster, and so on and so forth, Party PD, for this last, possibly last, game in the series. If Mad Kings can take back the win from the loss of Meepo in the last game, we'll see what exactly Mad Kings will have in up their sleeve. They ban out the Darkseer or the Slardar. Looks like it's just going to be the pretty typical bans that you would see at the very beginning of the game.
Reserve time.
They will ban out the Underlord, actually, Doo-Wop. Actually, they used the Underlord last game, so it looks like they just didn't want to give Mad Kings the possibility of using it themselves. Mad Kings now do have the possibility of picking up the Shadow Demon and or the Luna. Or no, actually, if they need to either ban one of those two wombo combos, but of course, Luna could still be extremely viable in the game, even if Shadow Demon is not available. So at this point, Mad King is deciding, do they want to ban out the devious possible combination, the Luna and the Illusion battle? Or will Mad Kings just stick with some other plan? Lo and behold, ladies and gentlemen, Shadow Demon made it through the bans. Leshrac, up for Mad Kings. Juggernaut as the other ban from Mad Kings. Doo-Wop, pick up the Shadow Demon.
Five seconds remaining. Reserve time.
I think this is a debate on whether or not Mad Kings want to pick up the Luna. But who knows? Who knows? Do they let Doo-Wop claim the most devious combination of them all, Shadow Demon into Luna? Or will Mad Kings take Luna for themselves? They're using up a lot of their spare time to figure out if that's what they want to do here. A lot of their spare time, actually. And they pick up Undying instead, so looks like they did leave the Luna out there if Doo-Wop were wanting to take it, but of course Undying pretty strong as well when it comes to counteracting the fight illusion battle from Doo-Wop, as we saw in Team Freedom's game, where they baited out the Luna pick. Now it looks like Doo-Wop is trying to figure out if they want that. They don't want to do it just yet. Lifestealer will be the pickup instead for Doo-Wop. Mad Kings, they now have the option whether or not they want to ban out that Luna, thinking that Doo-Wop will still grab it, or do they not read Doo-Wop's draft correctly, or if whatever draft they're doing, in case I even get it wrong, will they end up leaving that up and available?
Radiant Team ban.
They will ban out the Ogre McGee. Seemed to be extremely strong in the last game, and Weaver to be the other ban. So if this was a drow lineup coming out from Mad Kings that is no longer available, no, it's still available, obviously. They can still run a drow without the Weaver. The Weaver, pretty big part in that equation.
Radiant team back.
Abaddon will be the last band in the second stage here by Doo-Wop. So, looks like they just don't want to deal with these certain heroes that still cause them a little bit of problems. Mad Kings, they can go ahead and figure out what they want to do at this point. Whether or not they even want to run the Meepo again is the question. Maybe it's like Mad Kings, they thought, maybe we could still run it afterwards anyway. They pick up the Sand King. That'll probably be the better offlane compared to what they had last game, which obviously didn't really do that well, but it was okay. Abaddon was still able to apply a lot of pressure to Snake King.
Reserve time.
But Mad Kings, they pick up the Sand King for the offlane hero, most likely pretty one of the pretty strong offlane heroes at this current patch.
Legion Commander.
And they pick up Legion Commander. So it looks like they do have a somewhat of an idea of what they want to do here. Doo-Wop will end up running a Legion Commander. It'll be very interesting to figure out what the return plan is. This is actually the Necrophos, so not too bad. It does manage to deny certain dual positions as well as just stunning to reduce the amount of fighting during a duel. So Necro, good for confirming kills here.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Keeper of the light.
Okay, looks like they're trying to find something to counter out the Sand King pushing capability. And they pick up the Keeper of the Light, which means this could be... no, definitely cannot be a last pick anti-mage, because that is beyond greedy. Mad Kings will ban out Sniper. Maybe Mad Kings will take the anti-mage. Who knows?
Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Doo-Wop. Will their last band be in this situation? First, Keeper of the Light. Mad Kings still need a really hard carry at this point. Maybe they try Meepo again. Question is, Doo-Wop ban it? Really need this hard carry. If do Mad Kings Doo-Wop ban the Meepo, this is gonna be another Meepo pickup here. Do they ban it, or is it a Luna? Okay, so they ban out Templar Assassin, which is pretty much just as good. This is good ban there. So I guess if the Meepo is the last pickup here.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Doo-Wop, they have 40 seconds to go ahead and figure out what exactly they want to do here as their last pickup. They take up the Magnus.
Dire
It looks like they're going for the natural right-click ability of the Legion Commander Lifestealer, the Magnus right-click Battle Fury. Mad Kings, what will they do?
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
What if they do end up picking up Meepo again? What if? Right? What if this is a 2-0 series and Doo-Wop 2-0 Mad Kings? Who knows? It went for Queen of Pain. So Mad Kings still somewhat of a very squishy lineup, but of course after a Lifestealer was picked up, that was maybe the way it was heading. So not really. They could do Legion Commander Infest Bombs, Magnus Infest Bombs. They could do a lot of Infest Bombs from the Lifestealer at this point. So a lot of capability and teamfight possibility coming from Doo-Wop. Not to mention teamfight removability, killing off the Sand King and the Undying really quickly. So it looks like they're going to go through their pick and ban, and or not like pick and ban, but like move the wards into the right spot, time, and so on and so forth, whereas we are going to wait 5 seconds. We did not wait the 5 seconds. We went like straight on in. All right, ladies and gentlemen, as always, we will start over on the side of the Radiant. We have Shadow Demon played by Viru. Keeper of the Light, going to be played by Sari. Magnus will be played by 747 Lifestealer on Yewar, and Legion Commander is going to be played by Snake King. Meanwhile, on the side of the Dire, we have Sand King is on Sword. Leshrac is going to be X. Necrophos is going to be piloted by Dara. Undying is going to be piloted by Fireflies, and Queen of Pain piloted by Attune. We're going to have Magnus continually say missing middle until he's no longer in the middle. And that's the end of that. So it looks like this game is going to be fairly 50-50 here. No aggression worth going out other than this one here. Actually, D wards the camp. So the small camp is now dewarded. It's not going to end up getting any pressure out there. It's going to be picking up another set of runes.
30 seconds to battle.
The overlay on. I'm going to get that in chat for the next minute and a half. Anyway. Looks like they do want to try set up something here. No, they're not. It's going to go 2-2 even. 747 to grab the first one. No engagements going on there. There was the ward that spotted him the whole time. However, so. Queen of Pain, one of the few heroes to actually be able to get to the mid on time. Attune will be on the Queen. Can't wait to see the chat say that I left the overlay on again. 747 is in the mid with the Magnus. No surprises with a mid Keeper of the Light. Be a tri-lane in the bottom here. Magnus is going to continue to low a little bit here. Madara getting pressured by Snaking in the top here. Oh, hang on. Okay, never mind. I just saw heroes all clumped up, and I'm like, someone's gonna die, right? But no, nothing's gonna happen. Yewar, having an okay time down here in the bottom. Healing Wave gonna go through. Hits MK for a lot. MK hits Sword for a lot. So MK, they have a really early lineup. They're gonna have to be able to pressure this pretty easily here. Or they're gonna have to be able to pressure this game, because Doo-Wop, they win the late game. There is no way that Mad Kings will be able to win the late game. Meanwhile, in the bot, though, there is something finally going on. Doo-Wop actually going to be the first one to fall, giving the first blood, Viru, to fall, X to claim. Yep. Yep, there goes the chat. Healing wave going to go through. It's going to be X who actually gets all the CS instead. Actually, Madara really low up on the top, snaking. If only he had a soul ring. Only he had a soul ring. 747, he's still getting pressured by these level 2 daggers now, not level 1 daggers. Thank you, Yultrek. I still love you too, even though I said your name wrong. It looks like there is going to be a dive here. Biru actually going for damage early instead of going for more lockdown and more damage, obviously, with Soulcatcher being pure and all. Actually, it looks like Legion Commander decided to go to the safe lane, power up through the shrine. He's going to jump on Madara with just one Q is probably going to end up doing the trick here. Bounty Rune to confirm. Taking. He's waiting for it. Meanwhile, actually, it is going to be Queen of Pain jumping on Serico here. The Queen of Pain. Oh my gosh. Yes, the Queen of Pain jumping on the Kotal. So hard. So difficult. Is that the Shrine too? Oh gosh, that was the Shrine too. So that was really bad. Shrine poppage. Queen only getting a little inch of it. Buff is going to have a pretty easy time farming against the Magnus, but when it comes to kills, especially off of an invisibility rune, that'll be a whole different story. Question is, 747, does he try to fight here? Snake King, he's trying to go on Madara. Madara with that new kind of overpowered ability, Ghost Shroud. Going to be able to avoid most of the damage, but Snake King turning around, just throwing his Q down, getting almost a lot of people in that. Madara trying to last hit some creeps to get some heals. Not going to find it. His Q is part of the heal now. Attune. Looks like 747 does not actually end up getting the jump on him. He's taking quite a bit of damage. Bottles here. So is the Queen's bottle, though. Both mid laners are going to be able to heal up quite a bit. Rune actually up in the top lane. Sarasand end up getting the rune in the bot. Looks like there is an engagement going on here. Lifestealer just trying to heal up, going for that somewhat minimal HP creep in the bot here, but minus 8 strength, it's really hard. And Kings, they have a lot of good early lineup, but unfortunately that lineup will not be able to carry them into the late game. Duop definitely not having fun in any of their lanes. Snaking trying his best to end up killing out Madara, but Madara has the advantage. Meanwhile, Biru ends up getting a kill in the bot lane. You can finally go to the bot lane now as we see Yewar just getting stunned up to hell here. Sword, is he going to end up getting chopped out here? Yewar, he's slowed up from the caustic finale. And Shadow Demon will end up getting a kill, though. That is something somewhat beneficial. It was actually really beneficial by the looks of it. 350-something gold. Oh, what the... Okay, well, that happened really quickly. Was that a duel, though? It was not. So, snaking... Managing to kill the Necro, but not for a duel, which was would have been much more beneficial. Meanwhile, though, back in the bot, we have Serico trying to get a jump on X. He's got no HP left after that wave goes through, and now they're going to try and turn on Firefly. Sword's going to be the target instead. Stun is available. He wants to use it strategically, however. He is going to be able to get out. And the Shrine not up yet. 195 seconds, so... That is definitely a run to the base activity. No, actually, he gets his Tranquil Boots, so he will just be able to Tranquil up. Rune top yet again. It's the Illusion Rune, so Queen of Pain not being that lucky with her rune pickups here. Going to have to suffice with the Bounty Rune. Pressure in the bot lane, starting to stack up as Lifestealer getting stunned to all hell. Two more right clicks will confirm his death. Sword to get the confirmed kill as well. It looks like it's, oh wow. Smash the buttons really hard or something. 35 and 7 on the Magnus and 29 and 9 on the Queen of Pain, 3 and 4 even. Looks like Snake King, he's trying to find a jump on anyone here. He can get the duel off a sword if he's not stunlocked for ages and years to come. Don't try to duel this time, Snake King. You're definitely going to go down here. The death will occur. Snake King, his first death, actually. 227 gold for that. Wave going out. They're not going to find the pickoff here. They're like, there's got to be vision here because they knew. They knew I was there. Are we going to see the Aghanim Scepter rush out for the Keeper of the Light is the question, though. We have our beautiful Necrophos here. Yewar lining up for an attack. Madara, though, he has his W. He will end up hitting at that heal. Just so strong, actually. Infest Bomb not going to actually land on any targets. Madara trying to get the jump on Biru. Ult something or anything. Legion Commander not here either. It looks like the Sand King here, though. Will they get the ults off on Madara quick enough? They will not, and Yewar will just walk on out. Biru, though, he's getting low. The Scythe is still available. He almost throws it down. Okay, now swords. That ends up getting the kill, and it looks like he's going to get Biru as well. The heal bomb to slowly go and kill him. There it goes. Slowly went and killed him. Meanwhile, sword actually dies to Snaking with some immediate Q damage. Fire, he is going to get it, but there is going to be literally no procs happening during that attack. Not get the dual damage, and Snaking still getting the right click kill, not the dual damage. And Madara doing okay now. He's going for the mechanism, but it's still a like off lane. I still want to kind of help kind of build. It looks like Madara getting pressured on by Snaking here. Definitely a kind of like a brother rival here, except they're nothing like brothers, but we'll just say that they are and then we'll roll with it, right? Anyway, it looks like it is 53 and 8, 45 and 10 for this Queen of Pain, who is still just camping out in the jungle slash mid. Doing perfectly fine. Scan goes out. They find that the poll is happening. Looks like Yewar, though, slowed up down here. Nothing. Okay, there's nothing that's going to come of that. There are other heroes here, however. Are they going to be able to jump on Yewar? There's so many creeps. All they have to do is to find him initially, and they don't find him at all. More seconds left on his Q if he needs to be able to kill somebody. The Q does go out, but isn't enough to kill Sword. I think so. He does manage to get the infest. The bomb goes off, but not going to go on anyone in particular. Disruption at perfect times. Sword, though, RP'd into death. X to get the other kill. Queen of Pain down here as well with a DD rune. Snaking, he wants to try and get the duel. No duel be heard. Actually, I might be wrong. It looks like Snaking, it's only level 1 blink. She's got no boots, and Snaking does. The duel's gonna happen. The DD, though. Duel? Gonna happen? Not gonna happen. They just can't risk it with that double damage on the Queen of Pain. Looks like I'm wrong, actually. Or maybe he was baiting out that invis rune. I don't know. Why did he just stand there? Why did he just stand there and not grab that invis rune? He probably could have grabbed it. I mean, he knows that Snake King's invis. There's actually a sentry ward that's down in the mid that'll find him. But meanwhile, Biru will end up going down to a lot of combinations of stuns. MK is doing exactly what they need to do and pressure the early game as much as possible with as much of stuns that they've got. King coming up from behind. They want to get that duel on a tune. Now is the time. He's actually revealed at the last second there. Tower getting a clip of him right there. That's where it happened, right there. Could have actually been a good grab, but I guess not. So it looks like mid tower will be the name of the game here. It's definitely going to go down. They will expend the fortification for it. And MK will go ahead and try to pressure this bot tower while everything's going down. Meanwhile, top tower also under attack. The rest of the heroes are rotating in. Snaking, no blink dagger just yet. Blink dagger is also the name of the game. He needs to get out, though. He doesn't want to get jumped on. Four heroes now in the bot. Two heroes actually coming from Duop. Like this bot tower is definitely not going to have an easy time. And going to be used from the Dire, not going to pick up anyone getting ready for a jump or anything, just that. Dire will end up claiming a tower, and looks like they need to play a little bit more defensively. MK getting ready for something here, but they do have the ults available for Sword. snaking. Being a little bit risky here. Madara playing even more risky. He's underneath the tower. Hits his W. Perfect timing, though. He manages to not get hit at all. The ult to go down as well. Madara to get one kill, as well as Biru to go down by the Queen of Pain scream. And they're like, the totem went up, and that's why we died. Well, it's definitely not the reason why we died. Totem is not the reason why anyone died. So MK, again, they're expressing their ability. They have to take out the game quick and easy. Four BKBs are picked up and Yewar gets farmed, but it's 12 minutes now. We can switch the net worth, where we have the Magnus as the highest person with the net worth on the side of the Radiant. Necro, Queen to follow. Two mangoes. Question is this Legion Commander gonna be able to come online quick enough? Who knows? You know, this is the only downside to not having a co-caster. Weird, awkward silences. But they will need to really aggress the game, like, as soon as possible. Mad Kings cannot win the late, and I don't think they can win the late, like, mid-game. So, like, at the 25-minute mark, there's no way they can really pull back if everyone's ready and farmed. If Legion Commander get a duel, maybe. Maybe. Wave goes out. Madara gets hit. But the rest of the team is here. Quomp throwing down the veil. They're saying they got the shrine available, but of course 747 up here with sword. Blink dagger also on sword. This is a carry Magnus, so he's got the Echo Saber blink next on his pickup list. He is going ahead and going to head out. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Yeah, it looks like it's just everyone's just gonna head out now. No one's gonna stay up here in the top tower. 4-7. You can't go out there, man. You know it's more than just fireflies. Don't do it. 7. Okay, that's fine. You did do that at least. Smoke going up. No way to detect it, so they gotta be careful. They could go straight onto this Kotal in the mid. Wave going through. We'll clean up the wave. Looks like they found their target location. Nothing really here just yet. Even a TP being thrown back out. Yewar back up to the top. Like they're saying, we gotta go take some towers or deal some damage, because Snake King has no dual damage. So, first Blink Dagger might be able to change that. Looks like the smoke rotation about to end. Oh, this is a second smoke, actually. The sword's still affected by it. Attune. They are gonna try and go on the Kotal in the mid. Another wave going through. They see him. They go on him, though. Actually, is revealed. They see fireflies. They don't see X, though. Head to the high ground. Heroes coming through here. X, they're revealed at the last second. They're actually seen. There's no way that the Kotal will... Okay, never mind. I was gonna say, there's no way that he should live, but he did. He managed to get out. Biru almost popping his ult down. They want to find a target, though. Everyone's all clumped up in the forest. Here they find everyone. The ult goes down. Disruption, though, will end up saving whoever was in there. X will end up going down 747 to claim that. Madara next on the to die list here. Duel damage, or duel goes out on the Sand King, actually, and not Madara, who's almost dead. The Queen Scream almost killing off everybody, though. 747 trying to kill some more people, though. Sword trying to dive and kill somebody underneath the tower. Triple kill going there, and Firefly is going down to Yewar. This is a really good fight for Doo-Wop, and this is exactly what they needed to come back. Everyone lived as well. Nobody went down, and they killed a lot of the cores. Not Queen of Pain. A lot of pinging, saying there could be wards here, there could not be. There definitely is not, but whatever. Add a 2-minute delay, so they probably don't even see me talking about that if they were watching. But it looks like, it looks like that team fight definitely going in the way of Doo-Wop. Almost, Atune almost killing off two heroes. They both got, like, extremely low. Now Doo-Wop finally have some of their heroes back on the top of the net worth. Whereas post that fight, or pre that fight, Lifestealer was underneath the Queen of Pain. So, millions of bounty runes and illusion runes being picked up. I don't know why that's not turned off, but it just, there's a lot. Shrine usage, 747 and friends. Go ahead and re-aggress their hold back on the game here. Yewar actually still going for the Echo Saver. He's gonna lifesteal up from this cannon. He's not really afraid of Atune right now. Atune not really afraid of him. Still no dual damage on Snake King though at 18 minutes. So it's a bit of an issue at this point. Snake King's gonna need some sort of reinforcements follow up with that. Of course, he is just going to go into the blade mail, so that could be the return there. During this time, where kind of nothing is happening, something will happen soon. Actually, now it's perfect time, now that we're paused again. Hopefully, I don't lag and problems again, because that's what happened last time we were paused. Shadow Demon, looks like he's going for Arcane Boots. I wouldn't be surprised if that's what's in the courier. It is not. And then the Keeper of the Light. Gonna go straight for that Aghanim Scepter. So yeah, the Ags Rush is on the Keeper. And he just picked up another piece. Level 9, so no tree yet. Level 15, Magnus is gonna go for the Silver's Edge. He went for 50 damage and 25 attack speed. Lifestealer, the plus 5 all stats. And he just picked up the Echo Saber, most likely into the Desolator. Legion Commander, the Blade Mail, and plus 7 strength. Meanwhile, on the side of the Dire. Oh my gosh. Meanwhile, on the side of the Dire, Sand King still going for that Force Staff. Level 9. Last track, level 8, going for the Urn, by the looks of it. Yep. Necrophos, he's got the Guardian Greaves, and he's going to go for the Heart of Athos. 6 strength as his tree as well. Undying, level 8, going for the Mechanism, nothing on him. Queen of Pain, going for the Lincolns, by the looks of it. And nothing in her tree as well. Wow, perfect timing. The only downside to this whole entire arrangement is that Legion Commander still has no dual damage. Which is quite bad. Kings are, I'm sure, not having a great time knowing that they kind of gave away a little bit of the game here. 747, not going to get jumped on by Madara just yet. Not ready. I'm not ready. I be able to escape. Will be the Shadow Blade that was also picked up on him as well. Finally, so he does have an escape. Kings, I can't imagine they're happy right now, losing that previous team fight right before the great turn. It looks like there's a taunt going out. Sand King is gonna get the duel, and the first duel damage goes through. 14 damage, Snake King is a god. He's got dual damage, but looks like Snake King will be the one to fall, as well as Biru from Atune's Scream of Pain. Tonic Wave. Yewar, the only one to escape from this engagement. Actually, not just yet. 747 Shadowblade. They're gonna turn on Fireflies here, actually. It's gonna be really good. RP goes out as well, putting everybody in a little mist of a damage there. Madara, though, trying to confirm some sort of kill. Bomb goes out. The Scythe is still available to drop on 747. No, they're gonna go straight on the Lifestealer instead. Yewar to go down. That's actually the team fight Madara. Mad Kings needed this whole time. Oh, goes down to the stun as well. That's a 5-man kill streak going down. Well, so Mad Kings, now they are starting to look up on to up to the grass at this point. 50 seconds with no lifestealer and 40 with no Magnus. Oh, that's good. It doesn't show your illusions anymore. Dara's just gonna walk right on through the illusions. They might think this Necro is real. Not real. Oh, hang on. There is a duel happening in the background here, though. Leshrac, he will end up going down. That's the second set of duel damage for Snaking. Finally, some duel damage for Snaking. It's been extremely difficult to end up getting duel damage. DP is gonna get scouted out. Yewar. Else to follow after that, of course. Meanwhile, those swords just hanging out, waiting for a good team fight. They're saying now is the time. And King will jump in. Yewar throwing up his magic immunity. They did not see sword. Now they do. Will be able to blink out just in time. A lot of dire vision hanging around up here. They're like, this is where a ward is. There it is. Damn, 100 gold. Snaking, getting dual damage. Let's just keep that in mind, folks. He's finally getting dual damage. It's the end of the game. He's got dual damage. Being of end of the game, we have Yewar dusted up over here. He thinks that it's 747, but nowhere near. We got a Toon running around with a haste rune trying to jump somebody. Yewar obviously not going to try and slow the Queen of Pain to start an engagement here, but all of MK are here, or technically near here. Madara will sweep on through it. It looks like they're gonna disengage from this for now. Oh no, Doo-Wop putting down an aggressive smoke. It's gonna be revealed immediately. They're like, look out, boys and girls. There's a smoke going out here. Looks like the RP is gonna be used as two get caught in the RP. Sand King ult is gonna be destroyed through the channeling, but he will be able to get out. No, that wasn't Sand King that got disrupted. No, it was Sand King that got disrupted. Snake King trying to confirm the kill on X. Meanwhile, 747 killing off Fireflies. Madara, are they going to be able to get out? There's no stun available to slow all the magic damage. Yewar will confirm that kill. Meanwhile, Queen of Pain trying to... Oh, not Queen of Pain. Queen of Pain is escaping the other way. Sword trying to escape. Extremely low HP. The TP. Yewar, is he going to find Sword? He will. There's another kill going to Yewar. And this is the Roshan. So I said it once, I'll say it again. That is definitely a team fight that Doo-Wop needed in order to take that team fight pretty effectively. Snaking, 28 dual damage, did not end up getting a dual victory in that engagement, but oh no, he did actually. He didn't get the win though, but he got the duel. So it looks like the Roshan will go down and Yewar to be the one to claim. Be the infest snaking the regen rune to instantly disappear. Actually, I don't know how that happened. Oh, because it was a regen rune initially and then it went down. No, what the hell, regen rune down there. Snaking trying to find a pick off for a duel here. Literally anyone would work. They might find the Sand King. That'd be the best bet here. Sand King. Oh no, they know that he blinked down in. Snaking, turn around, brother. Duel do it. No sight. And looks like that is definitely the death of Sand King. Heals all around though, trying to save him out here. Snake King getting extremely low. The disruption might be needed to prevent the death of anyone here. Yewar trying to go on Madara here, but the perfect 3-man RP, it's gonna be there. The damage will follow up and everyone goes down. The killing spree to fall. The disruption there at a perfect time. Fireflies will go down as well. Doo-Wop, they understand. It's gotten to the 24-minute mark, like I said, folks. And Doo-Wop going to take this to the grave. Doo-Wop going to work on pushing down the middle here. Doo-Wop, by the way, already has game number one. If they win the end of this series, and I don't know what happens to the Mad Kings, but they lose. Pretty much it. Desolator out on Yewar, finally. Now it's going to be enough damage that's thrown out on the heroes here. Meanwhile, in the bot, though, Shadow Demon what I don't know what he was trying to do, but X is now up here, just taking a little bit of tick damage. Maybe trying to scout out some wards. I don't know. Why is he letting him get hit? All right, well, meanwhile, the top tower will end up going down, 747 to claim that one. And the Daedalus is going to be the next on the to-do list for the Magnus. So a lot of damage making. Infest Bomb, 42 dual damage. They need one target. Literally any of these two will do. They need him alone. Looks like that's not, it looks like they don't care about that. Oh, nope, okay. Not gonna be able to get the duel off of that. Considering there might be wards there. Snaking. He's out, going to the bottom. It's gonna be X that's hexed up. Well, not hexed up, but disruption. The slow is gonna be out on X though. The dual damage is gonna go through. That will become dual damage. The only one to fall is Biru, but in exchange for X and a tune. 747, he's trying to find a pickoff. There's no mid tower here. He can just pull them. They throw down a sentry. They gotta do it now. It's gonna be the stun, the follow-up, the everything else. It's gonna be the death of Madara. And now it's Fireflies going down as well. The shrine usage, even shrine usage as well. Fall. So it looks like that's what happened there. A lot of engagements. This is pure dirty for the Magnus. This Daedalus already up and running. The shrine's next to fall. Yeah, we'll go through the items right now since a lot of people are dying. Shadow Demon, he's going into the Helm of the Dominator. Keeper of the Light, the Blink Dagger, and the Gem is on him. Magnus going for, looks like a Manta Silver, that's still. Lifestealer going for the Diffusal Blade. Legion Commander for a Black King Bar. Sand King up the Force Staff just now. Lesrak still trying to go for a Yules. Kvothe going for a Sheep Stick. Undying, looks like actually there's a fight going on, but Awar, he ain't scared. He's gonna deal as much damage as he can here. A lot of Zombos on the field for some reason. Don't know why I'm getting some... Oh, it's not frame skips. Biru is just slow to hell here. He's got a dagger on him at the same time. But first, X will be the one to fall. Awar still has the Aegis. Another kill going out. The Quap will end up dying. Will they get the Necro kill in time, though? The split from the bomb. Yeah, it'll go down. Awar will confirm Fireflies. Got no HP. The buyback is going to be there. It's going to be the pullback going out. The good game is called. Necrophos, the only one to buy back, has decided to leave. That is good game, folks. 28 minutes of doo-wop. We're playing game number two. Doo-wop versus Mad Kings in the KOD League season number two. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls.